Hi guys, today we're going to see how you can find low competition keywords for your website. Let's say you have a website and you want your content to rank on Google. Now if you create content with a random topic or keyword which already has a lot of competition, then there's a good chance your content will never appear on the search results, as there are bigger sites which have already covered that keyword. So to make your content appear in the search results, you need to find a keyword which has a low competition and create content for that keyword. In this video, we're going to see how you can find low competition keywords for your website, which can be easily ranked on Google. So let's get started. I'm Brian from Website Learners, and let's find low competition keywords for our website.
First, let's look at our site for which we are going to find our keywords. Here it is. This is my WordPress site, and as you can see, it's about gaming laptops. If you don't have a website, you can watch this video to learn how to create one. Now, to find low competition keywords for our site, we are going to do three steps. The first step is to find the keywords which people are searching for related to your website. So, to find the keywords, let's open a new tab and go to keyword.io. Now press enter and you will get this page. Now this is the site which is going to help us find our keywords. Now here, enter your website's topic. Since my website is about gaming laptops, I'm going to enter that. And now if we click search, you can see that we have got a list of all the keywords which people search for related to our topic. So these are the terms which people are using commonly on Google. Once you have found these keywords, we can go to the next step, which is to select the keywords for which you want to write the content. So just pick the topics which you can easily write about on your blog or your website. I'm going to choose these topics. And as you can see, they have been added to this list. Okay, so once you have selected the keywords you want, you can go to step 3, which is to find the competition of these keywords. So to find the competition of these keywords, we're going to do two steps. The first step is to create an account on an SEO tool called KWFinder. So to create the account, let's go to this tab. Now just click the link below this video and it will take you to this page. You can also go to wl.tools/kwfinder to reach this page. And once you're on this page, click create free account. And then fill up these details. So I'm going to enter my email and a password and click create account. And now our account is created. Once you have created the account, let's go to this tab. And now we can go to the final step of finding the competition for these keywords, which is to add these keywords into this tool. So to add the keywords, let's go back to the tool and then click here and select KWFinder. Now click Go to App and then click Import. Now to find the competition of your keywords, you need to first enter them here. So let's go to our Keywords tab and then select these keywords and copy them. Then go back to KWFinder and paste the keywords here. So now we have added the keywords we want into this tool. Now to find the competition of these keywords, just click Process Keywords And now you can see that here we have got the competition for each keyword. So this number shows how difficult it is to rank for this keyword. Now to get more information about this number, let's click here. And now you'll get this window, which shows you which keywords are easy to rank for and which are difficult. Now to find a keyword which is easy to rank for, we need to find a keyword which has a difficulty of less than 30. So let's close this. And let's try to find a keyword with a difficulty of less than 30. Now here you can see that this keyword has a difficulty score of 77. Which means, if we create content for it, it is unlikely to rank on Google. So let's scroll down. Now here you can see that we have a keyword which has a difficulty of 18. Which means, it has a low competition and it is relatively easy to rank for. Now to get all low competition keywords, just click the keyword difficulty column here. And now you will find the low competition keywords at the top. Okay, so once you get this, next, you need to look at the number of searches each keyword gets in a month. So here you can see that this keyword has a low difficulty, but very few people are searching for it. But if you look at this keyword, you can see that it also has a low difficulty, but it has a lot more people searching for it. So this means, if we write content for this keyword on our website, it is easier to rank and can attract more people to our website. So now you need to pick a keyword from here which has low competition and has a lot of searches. So I am going to select this keyword. And as you can see, this keyword is still easy to rank for. Once you've selected your keyword, in order to rank your site for this keyword, you need to write content on your website for this keyword. So to write the content, let's go to our website. Now this is a site which I have built with WordPress. If you don't have a website, you can watch this video to learn how to make one. Now to write new content on our website, let's go to New and click Post. And it will take you to this page where you can write a blog post article like this. Now, here you need to enter the title of your post. So enter the same keyword which you found in KWFinder. I'm going to enter the best gaming laptop under $1,000. Now make sure your title contains the keyword which you found in the previous step. Now once you've entered your title, next, you need to write the content for this title. So make sure you research well about the topic and write a useful piece of content for the person who searched for this topic on Google. I am going to add my content. And once you have added the content, next let's add the image like this. So let's click Set Featured Image. And then drag and drop an image like this. And your image will be added here. So now to publish this content on your site, just click Publish. And now, this content will be posted on your site. Now to see how it looks, let's click View Post. And as you can see, we have got our content here. So now we have successfully found a low competition keyword and have created a useful piece of content on that keyword.
Once you publish your content, Google will assess your content to see if it is useful or valuable to the user who searches for that keyword.
If Google thinks your content is suitable for this keyword, it will rank your site. And you will start getting visitors to this blog post.
So now you know how you can find low competition keywords for your website. Now the KWFinder is a premium SEO tool which is available on a free trial for 10 days.
Now after 10 days, if you don't want to pay for KWFinder and you want to find more low competition keywords, you can use an alternate tool which is free.
So next, let's see how you can find low competition keywords using the free tool. So to find the low competition keywords using the free tool, just click the link below this video and it will take you to this page.
Now this is the free tool we are going to use to find the competition of our keywords. So to find the competition, just click Import Keywords and then enter the keywords which you found in step 1. So let's go back to keyword.io and then copy these keywords and then paste it here. Now if we click Import Keywords, you can see that we can now see the difficulty of each keyword. Now if we click here, you can see the difficulty of the next keyword. So this is how you can find the competition of your keywords for free.
So that's it guys. Now you know how you can find low competition keywords for your website. If you want to see how much traffic your website is getting from Google, you can watch this video. And if you want to learn how to improve your SEO and rank your site on Google, you can watch this video. Also, make sure you subscribe to Website Learners to get more videos like this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.